Hi, this is Leah from OpenIntro. In this video, we will see how to carry out a confidence interval for a single proportion and how to find the minimum sample size for a given margin of error and confidence level. We're interested in estimating the proportion of students at a university who smoke. Out of a random sample of 200 students from this university, 40 students smoke. A. Calculate a 95% confidence interval for the proportion of students at this university who smoke and interpret this interval in context. So in order to structure our response, we're going to use what I've abbreviated the I4C framework. So this ICCCC stands for identify, choose, check, calculate, and conclude. And so when we do a confidence interval, it's nice to first identify what it is that we're trying to estimate. So we can identify the parameter of interest and the confidence level with which we'll estimate it. In this case, we want to estimate the proportion of students at this university who smoke, and we'll estimate that at the 95% confidence level. Next, we want to choose the correct confidence interval procedure. Because we have a proportion and we have one random sample, we're going to do a one proportion Z interval. With any inference procedure, we need to check that the conditions are satisfied. So here we want to check that we have one random sample of less than 10% of the population for independence, and the success failure condition, NP hat and N1 minus P hat are greater than or equal to 10. So are these satisfied here? Let's see. The problem states that we have a random sample, and we will have to assume that there's greater than 2,000 total students at this university, so that we are in fact sampling less than 10% of the population. Here n, the sample size is 200, p hat, the sample proportion, is 40 over 200. So we can plug those in and we see that both of these are greater than or equal to 10. Now we're ready to calculate. Confidence interval has the form point estimate plus or minus critical value times the standard error of the estimate. Our point estimate for the true proportion is the sample proportion, p hat. Because we're basing this on a normal distribution, our critical value is z star, and then we'll need the standard error of p hat. If we don't remember how to find the standard error of p hat, we can look it up. Here we see that the standard error of p hat is the square root of p hat 1 minus p hat over n. So we can substitute that in, and now we're ready to substitute in numbers. P hat, the sample proportion, we already said is 40 over 200. And then the sample size is 200. And now we just need Z star. So if we're not sure what Z star is, we can find a T table. On the T table, we'll look at rho infinity for Z star. So if we're trying to find Z star, we use rho infinity. And we want 95% confidence level. And so with rho infinity, 95% confidence level, we see that our critical value, Z star, is 1.96. So now we have the confidence interval and we can evaluate it. If you like, you can use a calculator shortcut. I'm going to use a TI here. And so I'm going to go to stat, over to tests. And because we have a single proportion and we're using a Z confidence interval, I'm going to choose one prop Z int. So I have to find one prop Z int. So one prop Z int. X is the number of yeses or successes. In this case, there were 40 students who smoked in the sample. So X is 40 out of a sample size of 200. We have our confidence level is 0.95. And so we can calculate. And this gives us the lower and upper bound to our confidence interval. So we can record those. And now we're ready to interpret our interval. We are 95% confident that the true parameter of interest is between our lower and upper bound. The parameter of interest we identified at the outset, that's the proportion of students at this university who smoke. So we are 95% confident that the true proportion of students at this university who smoke is between 0.145 and 0.255, or between 14.5% and 25.5%. So now we're ready for part B. If we want the margin of error to be no larger than 2% at the 95% confidence level for the proportion of students who smoke, how big of a sample would we need? So that is to say, what's the smallest sample size that would satisfy these conditions? We're looking at a proportion. So we have the general form of the confidence interval looks like this. And the margin of error is what comes after the plus or minus. So this is the margin of error term. And we want this to be no larger than 2%. That is, we want this to be less than or equal to 0.02. And we want to find the smallest n that will satisfy this. So because we're using 95% confidence level, we know z star is 1.96. And here we actually have a p hat. We have a sample proportion. That's 40 out of 200, which is 0.2. Now, in most cases, when you're trying to anticipate what sample size you should use, you won't have a good estimate for the true proportion. So if no sample proportion, if no p hat or estimate of p is given, use 0.5 as the estimate. Why would we do that? Because the standard error, the square root term, is maximized when we plug in p hat as 0.5. And so this will give us the most conservative approach, which is to say this will yield the largest n. Okay, so now we're ready to essentially solve for n. We can divide both sides by 0.196 and square both sides, etc. And then we're going to have that n is greater than or equal to 1,536.64. Now remember, n is the sample size, so it's a number of people, which has to be an integer. So we're looking for the smallest integer that satisfies that inequality. And so our final answer is that n would have to be 1,537. That's the smallest n that will satisfy these conditions. That's it for this video. You can find more free resources at openintro.org.